What's up, everybody? It's your boy, back at it again. You already know what video game we're playing. Alright, so today I'm just probably going to be practicing. I would like to just practice and not actually play any online matches, because I really need some practice. So, just to be clear, for anyone who wanted a fun update on my Guilty Gear experience, the reason I just booted up Faust is because I was playing matches against Ultimate Faust the other day. I'm pretty sure someone saw that, but what they might not have seen was that Ultimate Faust has literally been playing Gear for like 13 to 15 years. I forget the exact number, but the guy is literally just like a fucking grizzled veteran of Gear, and I didn't know that, and it's kind of a humbling realization to make that I was getting bopped by the best. And I think I really needed it, because like the guy was clearly having fun when he was playing too. Like he was trying some funny stuff. Will I even follow up on that? Faust, probably. He's pretty wide. But yeah. So long story short, the matches against Ultimate Faust were, you know, I got salty for anyone who did actually watch the video. But it's humbling. And I think I've needed that. I've needed someone to bop the respect for the game, but also respect for myself back into it. Because I take this game very seriously, and I really do only know the half of it so far. Like, I only sort of know, like, how incompetent I am. Like, I'm at that level on the Dunning-Kruger scale. I believe that's what it's called. I can't do that. But anyways. On that note, so I sent that replay, or rather that video, to Krakatoa, world famous Faust player and button pusher and cheatbox user, and I had him critique that gameplay. So shout out to him for doing that. I very much appreciate that, him doing that. He had a wealth of good information to give me, and not just, you know, like, you should do X instead of Y, but, you know, giving me a lot to chew on. So here's the TLDR of what he gave me was... The TLDR is actually a list of things, but it's a good list of things. What he said was... Drumroll, please. A. Try to simplify your game plan. Your toolbox should consist of strong options that beat a spread of Fausts. Don't do anything without purpose. B. Once you get a general understanding of what beats what, look at how Faust would adjust to fear of said moves. C. Try to line up moves ahead of time to counter a particular mindset. This player will really like to jump or J2K on defense because I've done lots of command grab. That sounds like me. Have your high reward counterplay ready to go. I would love to, but I still don't quite know combos on this fucking character. It is a brief moment after he jumps off their head. Yeah. Anyways, D. Go into replay mode and check to see just what Faust is doing when blocking. This is a very Krakatoa specific thing, because I know that this guy likes to talk about defensive OS, and defensive OSs and stuff, like, you know, fuzzy mashing is like, people don't let's ignore the cub replay. People don't really talk about that all that much, but it's extremely important. Like, you know, if you're like, you know, fuzzy mashing to cover certain frame traps, or rather to cover certain mix-ups, and then, you know, they just do an airtight frame trap, like, you won't, nothing will happen. So it's a fuzzy OS. But anyway, accommodate for reactions in every situation. When going over the footage, look at moments when Faust is explicitly playing reactively. That should simplify what you need to do. E 2.1, Gamma Blade, Dash In Button, Chilling Q Shurikens, Teleport, FRC, JH, and Dash FD. These are your go-to options against your options against reactive Faust. E 2.2, Raw Alpha Blade, jumping in, raw teleports, air dashing around, jumping up and away. These encourage Faust to play reactively. F. Clean up your Oki. You're doing way too many different things and they're all too loose. I 100% agree with that. F.2. Command grab, tick throws, cross ups from jump in, air dash cross up is too reactable. You might as well try to just meaty CS outside of throw range. G, take a look at what Faust is doing when blocking on defense, in quotes. You may find better ideas for pressure instead of PS confirms. He can only jump, poke, or play reactively. Another option, figure out what beats what. Leave big, sudden gaps and look at punishing what happens as he leaves block stun. G.2. In pressure, suddenly teleports, or teleport FRC can trap against certain of our normals and jumps. Stopping pressure abruptly and going for 6H or 2H can lead to big rewards against J2K slash certain pokes. H. Finish your plate. Faust is whack to pick up off of JD slide, it seems. Find the right confirms. The universe splits in two when you drop a combo. The truer words have never been spoken. I tell you, really, it hasn't. The universe does, in fact, split in two when you drop a combo because it creates all sort of whack scenarios. That, like, specifically if you drop a combo, you didn't mean to do it, which means you shouldn't know the situation in which that happened. So, anyways. Let me read one or two more things from there. 2K and Metagiri. What the hell is Metagiri again? What is Metagiri? It's probably Pogo or something like that. Mix up slash Metagiri immediately after teleport. FRC into Metagiri. This sounds like something Elven. Metagiri is command throw. Or Metagiri is hack and slash. Unblockable, only turns on when you throw vulnerable. Okay, so what I have learned from talking with Ultimate Faust right now, I literally just sent him a message, long story short, saying like it was an honor to be bought by the best, and I've been humbled by our play. And he said, I don't know if I would say I'm the best by any means, just from Faust standpoint in general, I may have like top three, top four, maybe Faust in the US. Elven Shadow is as OG as me, maybe even more so. He's had intense experience since he moved to Japan for years. Bruce Krakatoa is such a lab monster that I can't compare, but I don't think he has some of the wild reach I do. Elven Shadow is basically the best US player as of now. I fully believe that. Elven Shadow has way more matchup experience than me. It took a couple of years out. I took a couple of years off, and Plus R came out, but Rollback made it playable on Steam. It's awesome. Okay, I'm not actually practicing. I'm literally just dicking around right now. Okay, so Metagiri is hack and slash. That is what I needed to know. It doesn't say Metagiri next to it. That should probably be updated on Dusty. Okay, but for now, let's go with some basic stuff and just go from there. Oop. Let me just practice that input real quick. Oh, that's not it. Okay, that's it. Let's do IAD back. Try that. So how far does that hurt box extend? I can't just, you know, straight up counter poke that, can I? No, I don't think so. Let me try something. Let's see how minus this is on block. So it's minus 11 on block. I wonder. Yeah, can I do that? Science points in now. Where does it hit it? It hits it pretty far into that animation. Wish I could see the hitboxes for this shit. Okay, well, I have been told by bears, and I believe it, that you can just 6 feet of shit on reaction. So you'll basically always clash. Oh, shit. You can just react to that, can you? Maybe. Bit of a tough one. Well, let's actually try some Clash OS with this. Actually, I want to see some. Can that just trade with it? No, you have to do that really preemptively. Yeah, no, you can't react to that shit. That would be a funny read. But, whoa, holy shit. Damn, that's crazy. Can I just push 2H on it? Like, if it's really close. That's when you do it. So if I can get a punish, it's not a consistent one. Yeah, and you know, no Faust with their assault is gonna be doing it this close. So you can't really get punishes on that on block, but you can just, you know, react with 6p. Or just do that. Yeah, Krakatoa is right. Just random fucking TK alphas to stuff ground movement and shit are like pretty powerful, it seems. Okay, so 6p, or maybe IB. Like, yeah, can't really see this working. Yeah. Oop. Yeah, like that's just not gonna happen. That maybe. But no, I wouldn't rely on actually punishing that move. Okay, so we can say that we can 6p it on reaction, and if it, you know, vaguely resembles a scalpel, then you can just 6p it, but it is kind of a tight reaction. So let's do like that. Let's try something else that's funny. Let's see. So does the flower like track? I forget. Sorry, I'm also chatting with Ultimate Faust right now because this guy's cool. Continue pressure on Pogo if you are smarticle. Let's try this. Or rather, that seems like a common option. Can I really just do that on block? Like, I can't imagine there can't be anything that Faust has on Pogo that actually beats that. Gotten the head flower. Is it playing this back? No, I think it's only playing back one. Let me just re-record to sanity check. Yeah, just fucking jump back, I guess. So this seems like it should just, you know, die. Or even better yet, literally just like... just do that. So, yeah, fuck. Can just react to the JH whiffing or not. Like, the best I could see him doing is the FB follow-up. Little jump, but like, I really can't see that even doing much against up back. God, fucking Ultimate Faust icon is even like a really old fucking 4chan meme. This guy and I are like kindred spirits, undoubtedly. What a guy. Okay, back to the lab. Back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. Yeah, I also have sincere doubts that pogo movement will do anything here, but let's just slab it to be sure. Interesting. Yeah, I can just tech out, so like, I don't give a shit about that option. Like, I'll gladly take getting whopped by that for the reward involved in hitting this. Could also do that. Yeah, no, I shouldn't even fuck with the other options here, honestly. Like, literally just up back. Unless maybe he chucks an item and it's a good item? Yeah, so delay the JH a little. Yeah, like, that does fuck all. And if he's a madman, he could time that flower in such a way that I guess it could maybe counterpoke the fucking JH, but, like, I have sincere doubts that any Faust would bother with that. At that point, you would literally just be better off doing normal pressure or just, you know, like, pogo RC instead. Yeah, no, I don't even think, like, fucking hammer would help in that scenario. Let's try it, though. Oop. Yeah, no, that's a hammer. Just fucking hold up back, looks like. Alright, cool. I have the solution to that. Okay. Now time for some funny stuff. So, what if Faust's Gatling's in the 6H? I need to learn how to block 6H. It's not debatable. I just have to get used to it. 5P 6H, and that's it. That's literally it. That's it? That's all that Gatling's in the 6H? That can't be it. That's probably it. That really is all that Gatling's in the 6H. Wait, why does 2D Gatling into 5K? That's literally a backwards Gatling. At least in usual gear priority. So that's fucking whack, but, well, fucking that, I guess. Let's do some funny stuff with 6H, then. Classic 6H item toss. Ugh, fuck that up. Fuck. I'm not getting the full half circle. Okay. Sure, why not? We'll just go with that for funsies. Okay, let's just try some funny stuff. Good lord, that button's so fucking big. Oh, it's so fucking big, dude. I can just gamma on reaction. Can I just DP it, like, really far range? Can I see the hitboxes on that? Please and thank you. So it has in and out hitboxes, so to speak. Or rather, close and out hitboxes, that is. That's not reliable, I think. Well, it'll hit faster when I'm closer. Lol. Looking to punish scalpel. Shit shifts him back too. Yeah, that does like shift his box back a little. Delay that 6H real good. Look at that. You need to can't. That's fucking. Literally need to do TK and then fucking Reshu. If you TK that, then you can House makes some weird noises. I think blocking 6H will just have to come with time, I guess. Okay, so I think I should go into replay and just deal with some of this stuff real quick. Did I pass a replay? I think I did. Come on, I really should be able to block that shit. Let's try that, I guess. So I try to FD break, just... So I should stand FD break. See what the frame advantage is there. Yeah, he definitely has frame advantage there. I think that's just like straight up plus. Good old run up 2H, that's something that fucking Krakatoa recommended. Nah, this is gonna be clean, I think. Wondered. Lol. Let's see him do something. So that drill, I think I could have countered better. So what did he say against drill? You'll want to cut pressure short in yellow 2H or 6H. Time for big boy counter hits. If you guess wrong, that's an okay, because showing Faust 2H is a yummy! As Krakatoa says, you understand the spread of options and cultivate player fear. Losing in a situation leads to more winning. Adjustments always happening when you don't succeed. I dodged a bullet, holy shit, is what he'll think even if it doesn't work. First sentence, then he said, and you will not feel so disempowered. Dive kick in 2H. Rising JP or jump FD wait button. Interesting. I like that option. I like that option a lot, Krakatoa. Tell me more. I should always be ready to FD on fucking... Try and FRC that one just for funsies. Get classed. Nice. So yeah, Rising JP specifically. Goes for 5k, you can DP on landing. Okay. So 6p is like... So, 2H is 5 billion years active. That has a hurtbox extension, so I can die to that. So in that particular situation, probably Rising JP is the safest option, or like Rising JD specifically. Can I pick up off JP there? Just out of curiosity. Well, if I super jump, obviously. Anyways. So yeah, Rising JP seems to be a good option there. Okay. Perhaps even Rising JD. Okay. We can work with that. No conversions. My conversions still do suck. In that situation. In any situation where I'm not, like, completely locked down, I think probably Love should get him, like, murderized or something. Oh, yeah, I have time to teleport for sure. I don't have to hold that shit for shit. So mini Faust is there, but whatever. I could go for... I want to go for a funny air throw, but that's probably not what I want here. So I just need to make it whiff. Defensively, I could do, like, literally just jump back. Going airborne, not my strongest option. Damn, that reaches kind of high. Another one. My Oki is still quite limp. So, alas. I wonder what about that situation. Okay, so that's pretty sensical. That was a good response, but that jump in though. I was already stuck with in 2P. I'm mashing DP really hard here, and I'm not even sure that's gonna help. Yeah. So that's kind of a mess. Whiffing the 2P there just hurts anyways. He likes that a lot. Doing 2K on hit, and then or J2K on hit, and then, or no, just JK, and then 6H. He does that a lot. Catch my jump startup? Really? No? Why am I not getting my IEDs? Anyways. Wake up, Far Slash somehow works out in my fucking favor. This whole sequence of events is interesting. Interesting. I like how that hits both times really late. Oh, I don't have meter. He has meter. Okay, so that just has a gap I can just, like, jump over. That I have to be able to do something about. I really wanted that drill there, but, like... just before I start that up. Rising JP. That really is just like Eldritch tech, isn't it? Or not Eldritch, it's just like, it's really nice tech to have. Works on basically every character too. Anyways, so Rising JP seems to be pretty strong. YOLO 2H or 6H. That doesn't seem to work. Sadly not. If I smoke crack, maybe. Lol. Can also do that if I block it. Always IB that shit. Okay, this is getting a little mind numbing. So let's find him catching me lacking. There's plenty of that in this set as far as I know. I backdashed that. Interesting. Can I just? Well, yeah, the gap is big enough. Yeah, the gap is big enough that I can just hold up back, or I can hold up. So that's still a pretty big gap there. Big enough that I can work with it. Let's go for some offense here. Well, no, I'm already going for, what is it? I really wanted drill here, but sadly I did not get it. What is the pickup on Faust anyways? I don't know. So I can aim to trade with Drill. Trade with Drill seems like a pretty worthy trade deal for me. Six eight has to be pretty early. Fast has a pretty fat ass hurt box there. Okay.
No blocku.
When does he do the 6H then? So he always does it after fucking JK. Could I just 6P that? Deadass. Like, I wake up 6P that if I'm smoking crack. Lol. Okay. Stop bugging. Devotion. Devotion. Lol. Get fucked. Wait. No. I need to learn a conversion off that. Like now, or I'm gonna fucking cry myself to sleep. I can do literally that. That's what I know. I doubt it, but nah, not even. Let me just check the fucking dust loop for this. Surely this is somewhere on here. Fast combos. I looked in the frame data section for combos. I have smarticles. JD counter it. Five hit. Yes, that's what I meant to say. 5H. Oh my god. All right, I see. Okay. All right, I feel you. Why does it have to be? You know what? I won't even think about it. I trust the Guilty Gear Wizards on this one. Yeet. So that's interesting too. I don't really know how to handle air tech situations. Granted, this is a drop combo, so as Krakatoa said, I'll just assume that the universe splits in two when you drop a combo. Like, this is how it works. And I believe it. I can definitely murder him for doing that. We fuck up those punishes. Yeah, this is just kind of a scramble in neutral. I'm more just looking for situations that I can actually, like, boil down. Rather than, like, neutral situations where it could be explained that it could make sense that I could do, you know, quote-unquote anything there. Yeah, this is a fuck scenario, I think, but, yeah, right here I can just DP. Where's Pup? Anyways. Yeah, Faust going for this shit is like, eh, you can just kill him for doing that. Rising JP, bro. Rising JP. Damn, what a button. Buffer DP. See, that JP will hit me standing. Okay. Went for that drill reset. What's the gap on that? Big enough.
Ah ha ha! Mush!
No. Can I rush you? Why am I? No, close slash wouldn't even dare work there. That will only give you pain. Mash 2H for funsies. Mash 5k, that doesn't work, but whatever. Mash DP obviously works in this scenario. Up back, and then awkward scenario. Maybe Rising JP instead is probably preferable. Damn, he takes fast out of that. I doubt that ever combos, but let's just find out. Really? That combos? That's weird. I guess counter hit. Mash 6P, I mean, I could see it happening, but I can't really think of many options that this would work against other than that. Mash Alpha Blade, I mean, I would like to do that, but sadly, no, it does not seem to work. Mash DP, obviously. Okay, 5P, that is a thing. That was funny. Das Boot. And then... Something that has been on my mind is that as I've started to keep my hands hovered off of the Smashbox, I've actually just found that, like the top part of my wrist gets sore, and I'm thinking that's because I'm not, like, you know, resting my hands. Also, so there's a gap there. So it definitely catches me up back in there. Mash DP. That doesn't work. Okay, these are all options. Okay. W. So here, here I could jump out, do stuff, basically, like, you know. But let's say I want to cover him doing far slash after. I guess I could go for air alpha, or go for alpha blade. I guess that's an option. that wanted to catch my jump out though. So unless I'm holding that shit like, you know, first frame, if I do a late jump there, yeah, it kills me. Yep, he sees me up backing at the wall. Let's try. Still clashes. So if that whiffs, I can probably do a lot of things there. R slash were, or rather 2S works. Yeah, so that works too. Okay. Ow. Caught my jump. Why'd that be catching my jump? I would have sworn that didn't work before. So how fast is Scalpel? Scalpel is 20 frame startup. I don't know if I trust myself to react to that, but I think I could just like, could just buffer DP. What beats it? Not 2D. Still catches FD. Interesting option. Nope, it'll still hit me on the latter end. Damn. Wonder if I can mash 5P. Science point to no. 2K? No, I don't even know why I asked. Nope. So 2H... fucking Scalpel is pretty baller. Can 6P and mash DP after, but otherwise... Well, buffer DP seems to have never hurt me in the past. Just kidding. Drill reset, so I want to do like rising JP on that, or 6P, or 5P. That drill. Let me just wind this back a little bit more. Just push 2H, my guy. 2H really seems like the button. Krakatoa is totally right. This button is so fucking funny. And that any Faust who sees this button should go, YUMMY! Yeah, because then I go into big boy combos. Can I legit just dash under it? That would be a lot to ask for. Lol. So what I'm doing here is I'm fishing for Abare options, and this guy really likes his Abare. So I can classify it into this person wants to do Abare, and then from there I can actually look for the Abare option that they're doing. And then, yeah. Okay. Obviously, I can also do 6P there, but... Yeah, fucking 2-8 seems to be my favorite option here. Just such a high reward that it's, you know... Such a high reward, and it's reliable enough that it's like, I want that. I want that very badly. Comes back in with item toss. So in this specific scenario, I really just want to hit him. Like, I want this guy dead. This guy called my mother mean names, and I really want him dead. So what do? Well, we got Robo here. So those buttons are mean. He's going for buttons outside of range, so I should be going for buttons. I can, I guess, do that. Sorry, puffing too much crack. Hey man, come on, that looks cool. Lol. That doesn't even clash. So what that also tells me is that I still need to work on my offense. Still doing drill there, can still do 6P, 2H, 5P, rising JP, DP. All with the P button, maybe. And the S button for DP. And I'm still not blocking 6H. Alright. I am a little worn out. I'm fucking tired. And I have an interview tomorrow, so I think I'm gonna call it a night.